Hi, and welcome to my new video about release on demand in the context of the Safe for DevOps Health Radar. This is also the last video on my series all around the Safe for DevOps Health Radar. Please note that everything that I'm going to say and everything that I'm going to show you is under the license of Scaled Agile. Please also note that the Scaled Agile framework is a framework. Use it as a toolbox. Take out of this toolbox what fits your needs and what solves your problems. Release on demand consists of the activities release, stabilize, measure, and learn. Let's have a look what we are doing there. Before release on demand, we have continuous exploration, continuous integration, and continuous deployment. And after that, we have release on demand. And this is the whole continuous delivery pipeline. I have created separate videos for continuous exploration, continuous integration, and continuous deployment. The continuous delivery pipeline and also the Safe for DevOps Health Radar starts with the bright ideas from the business, but also from the customer. We take these bright ideas and we extract the hypothesis behind this idea and putting these hypotheses as a hypothesis statement into epics. Then we go into collaborate and research, and there we need to identify the real customer need or the real market need behind such a hypothesis. After that, we are going to architect the minimal amount of architecture which is needed to prove this hypothesis. And then in synthesize, we are going to break down the epic into features which we can then bring onto a backlog, prioritize these features, and also create a roadmap and a vision. This concludes the continuous exploration, and we are going into continuous integration. In continuous integration, we are first going to take the features from the backlog and break the features down into user stories, which then are going to be developed. We commit the source code into the source code repository, where our code will be reintegrated with the rest of the code. The build server will build our code, will do the static code analysis, and also the unit testing. Out of the build step, we get a deployable artifact, which we are then going to test end to end. This artifact is then deployed into a staging environment, which is a production near environment. There we are going to do the final validation. This concludes now the continuous integration, and we are going into continuous deployment. Now we are going to continuously deploy our changes with the feature toggle off into production. After the successful deployment, we are going to verify if everything is okay in production, and we take for that a subset of the tests which we have already executed. After that, we are going to continuously monitor our production server, build up the alerting so that we are able to respond to certain things that can happen in production. And this brings us to release on demand. We have now continuously deployed new functionality with the feature toggle off into the production system. Now it's up to the business to decide when the time is right to release the new functionality to the users. Releasing new functionality is a business decision. The business needs to decide when the time is right to release a new functionality to a certain subset or to all of the users. So, how do we do release on demand? In my previous videos, I showed you that we need to separate deployment from release. A deployment is bringing the compiled or the source code into production with the feature toggle off. Releasing is switching on the feature toggle. And this is exactly how we do release on demand. Thanks to the continuous deployment, continuously deploying the new functionality into production with the feature toggle off, we have now all of the functionality already in production, and we are ready to release it when the business says now it's the right time to release this new functionality. After we have released the new functionality, either to a subset of the users or to all of the users, we of course need to stabilize and operate this system. And we do this by closely monitoring our system and responding to alerts. Meanwhile, we are also closely measuring. You remember back in Hypothesize, we identified the hypothesis and we also identified the leading indicator which show us if this hypothesis is true or false. Now we are measuring the business value and all of this data which show us if the hypothesis is true or false. And with these information, we can learn if we should invest more into this hypothesis or less into this hypothesis. If we should continue with this epic, or if we should stop this epic, or if we should implement more features, or if we should stop implementing features under this epic. And with all of this information, we are now able to go back into continuous exploration and start all over again, creating perhaps a new hypothesis or creating new features, new user story based on the information that we have just gathered. And this, all of this, enables us to build the right thing right. I have created for each one of the activities of release on demand a video. One for release, one for stabilize, one for measure, and one for learn. I get often asked the question, what is the lead time? What is the duration which we have for the whole cycle through continuous exploration, continuous integration, continuous deployment, and release on demand? And of course, the answer is it depends. But let's make a concrete example. Let's assume we have a website. And from the clients, we get the feedback that the workflow through this website is too long and they would prefer to have a faster workflow. So what we would do now is we create this hypothesis that with a faster workflow, we would have a customer need and we would fulfill this customer need. So we would then go and identify the real customer need behind that. Then we would architect the minimal amount of architecture which is needed to fulfill this new workflow request. We would then break down this epic into features, bring them on a backlog, prioritize them, and then break down the features into user stories, which we are then going to develop. We are committing the source code into the source code repository. It gets reintegrated with the rest of the code. We are going to go through the build step where we are going to build the deployable artifact. Then we are going to test end to end. We are going into the staging environment and we are continuously deploying this new functionality with the feature toggle off into production. There we are going to verify if everything is still okay, and if something happens, we are going to respond. Until now, no new functionality has yet been delivered to any customer. We just have created the hypothesis, we have brought the features and the user stories on the backlog, we have developed the code, and we have continuously deployed into the production environment with the feature toggle off. This whole cycle from continuous exploration, continuous integration through continuous deployment can of course be done in a maximum of a day if you are very, very fast, but usually this will be done in a sprint, so a 2-week sprint, or within 2 sprints, which is about 4 weeks. So now the new functionality is already in production and the business can of course test this new functionality on the staging environment, but when they say now it's the right time, then we can switch on the feature toggle. This can be done within seconds and then the new functionality can be released to a subset of the users or to all of the users. So therefore, the lead time for new ideas depends on how fast you are and how big the idea is. But in summary, we can say if it is a small idea, it can go through the whole cycle within an hour. If it's a bigger idea, then it will take a day. And if it's larger, then it will take you a 2-week sprint cycle. But of course, also if the ideas are bigger and they consist of multiple features you want to deliver, then of course, this can also take longer. But with the continuous deployment, you can continuously deploy into the production environment, and with the feature toggles, you can enable or disable certain features and release incrementally value to your customers. And this is the big benefit of having such a continuous delivery pipeline. So therefore, what is the output of the release on demand step? The output is, of course, you have released the functionality and you have delivered business value to a subset or to all of your customers. And of course, what you want to ensure during this release on demand is that your production environment is stable, reliable, available, supportable, and secure, which means you need to meet the SLOs and the defined SLAs. During the release on demand, you are going to get qualitative and quantitative feedback from your customer and also from your monitoring system, whatever the hypothesis which was behind the idea is true or not. And this enables you to make decisions whether you are going to invest more into epics or features or less into epics and features. And this enables you to build the right thing right. And of course, it also enables you to continuously improve your continuous delivery pipeline. By continuously deploying new functionality into the production environment with the feature toggle off, we can ensure that the risk is small because we deploy small amounts of new functionality into the production environment with a low risk. And with that, we are also able to give the business the opportunity to say when the time is right to release new functionality to a subset of the users or to all of the users. And this gives the business the opportunity to decide when the time is right to maximize the impact of new functionality and maximize the value for the users. And this is the big benefit of having such a continuous delivery pipeline. And this concludes the series about the Safer DevOps Health Radar. We are now at the end of all of these videos which I have done around the Safer DevOps Health Radar. And with that, please leave me a thumbs up if you liked my videos and don't forget to subscribe to this channel.